need to learn the flat nine. There's the nine.
So there's the nine. You flatten the nine, you hold here.
Oh, you just go, you double this one.
Yeah.
So what do you, so where is this
D
one?
Is the ninth, D flat is the flat nine. This is the
This is covering the B string, correct. The second string. Correct. Okay.
So that's the raised nine.
Raised nine. The nine and the flat nine. Gotcha.
Well, this chord will resolve to an F. It's nothing but a jazzed up seventh.
Okay. Well, it'll resolve to. Is that a C?
That's a C.
Okay. So it resolves to the four chord is what
to
you're
the four
saying.
Chord, right. Gotcha. In some description, probably gotcha. That.
Okay.
Okay. F major seven. But look at.
Now what did you
that's
do
the there? Diminish.
Okay.
With the third of this chord in the root. Satisfies the resolution of the diminished chord in a half step to an F.
Gotcha.
The trick is that this C7 flat 9, you can substitute a diminished with the third in the root, which would be E diminished, and resolve it to the F.
Well, there's a lot of the same notes. I mean, not just the same notes.
Yeah.
Alphabetic, they're the same
The trick
notes.
Is knowing the upper structure, you know. This is the top of the ninth chord, starting on an E. And if you name it from this note, it's E minor 7 flat 5.
And you do have to choose what you're going to name it after, because
right.
those names are flexible.
Right. P.S. I love you. Dear, just thought I'd drop a line.
Yeah.
The weather's cool, the folks are fine.
Yeah.
I happened on that by accident.
You mean the arrangement of it?
This change.
And you're very choosy about your changes, which I like. Very tasty.
The folks are fine.
Show me that one that's like a 5-fret spread there that you're doing, and tell me what it is.
It's a minor 7.
Now, is that just that would work as an inside chord minor 7 no matter where you play it on the neck?
Or 7th flat 5.
And where, what is it named after?
This note.
Okay.
F minor
7. The note on the 5th string.
Minor 6th? I forget.
It's okay.
I do it by ear, you know.
Yes.
50-50.
Okay. I'm just intrigued.
See the bridge. I use this form repetitively and it seems to work.
And which form is that?
This.
Okay. I need some guidance like this to get me started, and I picked up a program for my iPod that does build some of these chords and then extrapolates them up the next, so you can slide them up to the next inversion, next position.
Yeah.
And and it names the intervals or the notes, whichever I choose.
Yeah.
Because I'm a numbers guy. I think by the numbers.
Me too.
Before I think of the names of the strings or the notes. I mean, if I'm thinking of the notes, I have to stop and reverse engineer that because I'm thinking of the number.
Me too.
Okay.
I do the same thing. Okay. My first teacher was my dad. He was an elegant musician. Pop. Six strings playing.
Oh, okay.
And he played rhythm for years. You know, he was Les Paul's rhythm player.
Okay, now did he drop D then too, or is you've adapted that?
He did on that particular arrangement.
Okay.
He did stuff like...
I see you play a jazz chord, something that I have to adapt for drop D, and I do it because I like the low note and I like moving the bass note up the string a bit for some of my higher neck play. But the thing I notice is you sure can't, I mean, with standard tuning, you can play your alternating basses much easier from the fifth to the sixth.
But you can't do that.
It's hard, but with your jazz positions, it looks to me like there's some very convenient.
Yeah, there's some voicings that you just can't get otherwise that are beautiful.
Yes.
I can't think. Now, anyway, I started to tell you, I was playing this, that thing by Schumann that I play.
Johnny said that to you.
Yeah, he said, if you drop that string to D and leave it there, you'd solve a lot of those problems.
Okay.
I said, oh.
Well, I'll bet you I play more in drop D than I do not in drop D.
My problem is I keep trying to transpose things that are in E flat and so on to D, and you got to be careful how often you use that gag, or I think it's going to
What do you think it impairs you?
It just starts sounding monotonous.
But why would it be any more monotonous in D than in E flat? If you get monotonous in one, wouldn't you be monotonous in the other?
And that is a problem as well.
I'm not trying to challenge what you're saying. I'm just saying I've heard that used in discussions, particularly by jazz people, for people like me who tend to like our open keys.
Yeah.
Because I like my open strings for doing things with sustain and stuff. But I'm thinking, why can't you be just as creative in an open key as you can in a flat key or a
sharp key?
You
know, like Johnny says, I love open strings.
I do too.
That I remember the cornfields is in G.
Yeah. Well, you don't play only in E flat or B flat or whatever. But you don't shy away from those keys either. And I think part of that has to do with, it looks to me like you've built your structure around the inside chord matrix. And you tend to put your root, tell me if I'm right here, you tend to voice with roots on the fifth string rather than the sixth string a lot. Or the root key is based around your bass note being on the fifth string.
One of my A tunes is a tune that I haven't played up here yet.
Key of A tunes?
It's hard. No, one of my or one number of your one best. A okay. tunes, yeah, okay. is it's so peaceful in the country. It's a jazz ballad. Let's see, I played a tune that guy wrote.